It's time for Mr.
Fundamental!
Presented by no one.
Before we get into the breakdown, I just want to say that I really wanted to post more videos, especially at the start of the season, but I had to meet a deadline, but that's over with now. Last night's game between the Clippers and the Spurs was a treat. Well, at least for those who enjoy old school basketball. While the Clippers look every bit as good as advertised, even without Paul George, they were quite close to losing this game, and it's because of the Spurs' defense. This was basically the first possession. The ball never goes inside the three-point line. The shot clock winds down, allowing both DeRozan and Murray to swarm Kawhi, leading to this Hail Mary shot. Both teams had a slow start, and the first points came 2 minutes into the game. Kawhi tried to get going in early offense. He fumbles the ball, but just misses the floater. I want to highlight how well Aldridge positioned himself defensively throughout the game. He steps up to help on the drive. Seeing that Murray got back into position, he starts to retreat to his man. This makes Kawhi second guess his decision to pass, and throws him off his rhythm on the floater. Even without many great defenders, the Spurs played really good team defense. Mills is not the tallest or longest player, but his great positioning allowed him to tip the pass. In pick and rolls, their guards would chase the ball handler and get a hand up to contest a shot no matter what. They also made it very difficult for Kawhi in any sort of team offense. A quick double drag screen gets Kawhi some daylight, but look at how both Bellinelli and Gay are contesting the shot. In this pick and roll, Walker could hawk Kawhi, knowing that Poeltl will help if he gets blown by. All this pressure causes Kawhi to turn it over. Again, early offense for Kawhi doesn't work out, because three Spurs could help on his drive, since their men are near the half-court line. Off the screen, DeRozan chases Kawhi, and again, Aldridge positions himself well. He continuously stunts at Kawhi, but doesn't give up the pass to Harrell. DeRozan gets his hands up on Kawhi's shot, and it misses. I know Kawhi is used to hitting these shots, but the Spurs' physicality and contests really threw him off his rhythm. So how did the Clippers adjust? By letting Kawhi work in the mid-post area. The first two shots that Kawhi made were almost identical, a face-up mid-range jumper. The Spurs didn't have a good wing defender to guard him one-on-one in the post, and couldn't send help either, because of Kawhi's new playmaking ability. I'll talk more about Kawhi's new skill in another video. These post-ups weren't just for Kawhi either. Harkless did some damage as well. Even after he picked up his dribble, a nice pivot gets him an easy layup. Although he was called the offensive foul, you can see the Clippers' emphasis of using their size advantage. Their second leading scorer struggled last night, and this possession explains why. On the drive, Lou Will is seeking contact with his left shoulder. Walker contorts his body to avoid the foul. Lou Will counters with a step through, and usually results in a layup. But because Walker avoided the contact, he's now on Lou Will's strong hand, allowing him to contest the floater. It also helped that Poeltl contested from the left side as well. But what Lou Will did was using the defense's attention to create for others. The snake dribble makes White trail behind even more. This also creates more separation between Poeltl and Harrell, leading to a dunk. This time, Lou Will sizes up Walker. The second pump fake makes Walker step up. When Lou Will's jab gets in front of Walker's foot, it's a GG. DeMar DeRozan basically carried the Spurs offense, and every time Shamit, Beverly, and Magruder switches on him, he'll take them into the posts. He was also hitting his mid-range jumpers off screens, and this is why I said it was an old-school game, because DeRozan and Kawhi were just trading possessions of post-ups and mid-range jumpers. Aldridge struggled the whole night, going 2-for-8 from the field. The shots he missed were ones that he usually makes, and it doesn't seem like the Clippers made any specific adjustments to slow him down. So it was just an off night for him. Derek White picked up his slack, and his mid-range jumpers forced the Clippers' defense to adjust. This sequence was definitely the highlight for him. Not only was he getting it done offensively, but his effort chasing players around screens had a huge impact, especially this block, and this charge against Harrell. But that wasn't enough to overcome their 18 turnovers, with most of them being travels and careless ones. The second half was when Kawhi started to heat up. After seeing the ball go in on this wide open three, and this typical Kawhi play, he got more comfortable with his shot. These contested mid-range jumpers just became easier. But what helped the Clippers hold on to their lead was their defensive adjustments and offensive rebounds. Early in the game, the Clippers rarely contested mid-range shots in pick and rolls, which is the Spurs' bread and butter. The Clippers started to pull away a little bit when they brought their centers higher up and contesting these shots. An underrated part of this adjustment is that Kawhi would be on the high side of Aldridge. Once he sees the shots go up, he gets beneath him to prevent the offensive rebound. The Spurs defended the three-point line well, but the Clippers' offensive rebounding offsetted their poor shooting. Off the miss, Patterson got the board, and the defensive scramble, leaving Subac wide open underneath the basket. Lou Will's drive draws the help to him, leaving Harrell open for the putback. Aldridge blocked a shot right into Harkless. The defense was scrambled because of all the helping, and they gave up the most wide open three of the night. In the end, the Clippers only won the Spurs by 6, even without Aldridge showing up, and an un-Spurs-like of 18 turnovers. Although I'm not sure how true this is, but this close game almost ended Doc Rivers' streak of undefeated Halloween games. The Clippers should shoot better from deep on other nights, but the Spurs did get a hand up on most of their shots. It's also interesting to see how Kawhi struggled within the team's offense compared to creating his own shot in the mid-post area. It seems like the Spurs' defense might be onto something, but it becomes a whole different story when Paul George returns from injury. Thank you for watching this video and I hope you enjoyed it. Please give it a thumbs up down below, subscribe, and I'll see you next time.